Well, the long season for the St. Cloud Huskies winds down to one final home series for the regular season at home. Welcome into the Herb Brooks National Hockey Center for your final game report. I'm your host, Katie Emmer. The Huskies completing the first game of the series tonight with a victory over the Colorado College Tigers 5-2. We're going to take a look at those highlights starting in the first. Both sides coming off of tough losses last weekend. The Huskies getting shut out at Denver and CC with a loss against Western Michigan last Saturday. They're both looking to capitalize. The Huskies come out on top right away. The powerful third line sets it up for Jacob Benson to rifle this one, getting the Huskies ahead right off the bat, but CC showed some spark to respond. Luke Gertes is taken off of his feet by a hit and majestically sets it up for Mason Berg. Tigers tie it up at once, and CC, well, they're gonna add another. Mason Berg again dishes it to senior forward Luke Gertes. Judd Peterson giving his life to defend the net, but CC gets it by. We're 2-1 Colorado, but leave it to one of the Paling twins to make some serious noise at the rink with this one. Nick Paling is set up by Ashawn and Schultz. Those three tie the game back up at twos. But wait, double take. There's another twin that wanted to make some noise. Jack Paling having a standout rookie season and, well, a standout first period. Huskies cover up the Tigers 3-2 to close out the first period, going into the second. And, you know, in the second, all I can say to start it is keep on keeping on, Smitty. Jeff Smith hopping back on the train to Savesville, blocking and saving everything and anything. Quiet second period for the Colorado College offense, but let's mention Alex LeClaire. He dominated as well, pipe to pipe, nothing by, score remaining 3-2 after the second period. All of those saves would continue on into the third and final period of play. Crickets on the scoreboard until just under 5 minutes. The Buffalo Sabres draft pick is in the right spot at the right time. Jack Paling sends it over. Huskies widen the gap 4-2, but the puck wouldn't stop there. The Huskies just kept it coming. Jacob Benson and Ben Storm set it up for Dan Tedesco as he claims his second goal of the season to send the boys on their way from the rink tonight with a win. Huskies again closing out the night with a 5-2 victory. Looking at the final stats from tonight's game, shots on goal in favor of Colorado College just by 125 opposed to 24 for the Huskies. But the St. Cloud Huskies offense dominating with faceoffs tonight, 28 opposed to 17 for the Tigers. No power play goals on either end, 22 saves for Jeff Smith between the pipes for the Huskies, and 20 saves for the Colorado College goalie Alex LeClaire.
It was a good win. I mean, I think we came out and didn't play our game completely the first period. I mean, I guess second half we played well.
First two periods we were doing good things offensively, but we just gave way too much up defensively. I mean, Schmitty, little rough start. Mm-hmm. I thought he really buckled down and had an excellent game.
It's always nice to play at the lead, and you know, I liked how we were playing in their zone. I thought, you know, my line was creating good offense, and so was Ryan Paling's line, and you know, we were getting a lot of chances. And coach said, going into the third period, the only way they're going to come back in the game is if we give them, you know, if we make mistakes and give them the puck. So, you know, we just tried our best to play a simple game, get pucks in deep, and go to work.
I felt in the third period we kept the puck going north. You know, they had to take a few more chances, which helped us because they were down. But we played a faster third period and kept the thing going up the rink. You know, Nick's been playing real well the second half, and you got to get rewarded. You have to feel good about your effort. It feels good to get that goal, and I know the bench was excited for him.
See, all year, I think he's been playing really good and been getting a lot of chances, and you know, we've been saying all along that it's bound to happen, and even though that was his first goal, the kid could have, you know, 10 goals this year.
Yeah, we were sitting in the dorms today, and I told him, dude, you got to get one. told him, we're going to get one tonight no matter what. So he did, and it was a good one.
No, Sean made a good play at the point. I just tried to get open, get in front of the net, and he saw me. And then, I don't know, was it the hook? Did they hook me or something?
Yeah,
is that
they
what
hooked
they called?
Yeah.
I honestly didn't even know. So.
Yeah, as you kind of swung out, the guy was kind of pulling on you a little bit.
Yeah, so. You know, if you move your feet, you get penalties. So
yeah, I think we felt good out there tonight. Obviously, Judd's going through a lot right now, but we just kind of put that to the side and, you know, kind of used it to our advantage. And it was good out there. We got a lot done, so it was nice.
You know, I just kind of felt like I was open in the slot, so I was yelling. I think it was Jack that passed it. Ooh. And their D was coming up as soon as he passed it, so I just had to get it off quick. And it was just kind of one of those, I think, weird shots that the goalie didn't really know where it was going or coming. So. I'll take it any day. You know, I went home on Wednesday and kind of said my goodbyes to my grandpa. before he was able to go, I told him I was going to get him a goal. So he smiled at me, and I just told my grandma, he's there, her, my aunt, my younger sister, Maddie, were there watching, and I called them, and they put me on speakerphone, and all three of them were at the phone crying and telling me how much they love me. And I just, like I said, I just told my grandma, I said, Grandma, that's Pete letting you know he's in heaven.
We like playing with Judd. He's really fast. He's a good player. So I think we had a good week of practice, and that just translated into the game.
Well, that's going to wrap it up for your highlights. The Huskies, again, completing game one with a victory over Colorado College. But the series isn't over. Game two tomorrow night here at the Herb Brooks Center. Well, we will have your full coverage starting at 7 p.m. on Husky Productions. Thank you for joining us here on HP. Everybody have a great rest of your night.